over for some time, Harold decided to go for a walk in the moonlight. There wasn't any moon, and Harold needed a moon for a walk in the moonlight. And he needed something to walk on. He made a long straight path so he wouldn't get lost. And he set off on his walk, taking his big purple crayon with him. But he didn't seem to be getting anywhere on the long straight path. So he left the path for a shortcut across a field. And the moon went with him. The shortcut led right to where Harold thought a forest ought to be. He didn't want to get lost in the woods, so he made a very small forest with just one tree. It turned out to be an apple tree. The apples would be very tasty, Harold thought, when they got ripe. So he put a frightening dragon under the tree to guard the apples. It was a terribly frightening dragon. It even frightened Harold. He backed away. His hand holding the purple crayon shook. Suddenly, he realized what was happening. But by then, Harold was over his head in an ocean. He came up thinking fast. And in no time, he was climbing aboard a trim little boat. He quickly set sail. And the moon sailed around.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. asleep at night. Have you ever seen such a sight? Maybe you screamed in fright. Let's see what my dream's like. There was beautiful flowers, smell and pick. They sword fight with a stick. It was a warm, sunny day when she walked through the tall forest and swam all day. And a nice place to play and sleep. And one night she fell down a hole. She never came out. Oh no, what a bore.
My dream home is untitled. Welcome, he said. Fuzziness and warmth enveloped her softly, beckoning. Enter the gate and creep slowly forward. Answer the enticing greeting. Led up to a room with 1,000 stairs. She pondered her options. Led herself into the big, steely box. Climbing in, she heard it crank upward and then stop. An evil frost climbed up her spine and met her halfway. Somehow she was ice. The steel prison dropped. There she lay. A depression tore the sand. The apocalypse.
Illusions of reality. In the midst of the dark, mysterious night, in the mind of the half-conscious sleeper, chaos, a cyclone of swirling thoughts, confused and darkened, combining and recoiling to make a terrified, pleasant, obscure image, playing in their innerly conscious victim. A flashing, racing scene of colors, shapes, shadows, feelings, thoughts. Oh, so many racing thoughts of illusion.
Exquisite corpse number 3, banana car. Banana boy crossed the street with smirk smirk. I didn't know that. Eat me, I like apple pie. Yeah, yeah. So then he ate the blue chunky soap. Then smirk smirk screamed. Stop, he said. I like school. I like to eat bananas. So Steve ran for his life against him. Then, Smurf Smurf got to a fire car.
Delicious pie go to waste. So Harold left a very hungry moose and a could see the window of his bedroom. He was tired, and he felt dark beginning to bed. He hoped he could see his bedroom window from the top of the mountain. But as he looked down over the other side, he slipped. And there wasn't any other side of the mountain. He was falling in thin air. But luckily, he kept his wits and his purple crayon. He made a balloon, and he grabbed onto it. And he made a basket under the balloon, big enough to stand in. He had a fine view from the building, but he couldn't see his window. He couldn't even see a house. So he made a house. And he landed the balloon on the grass in the front yard. None of the windows was his window. He tried to think where his window ought to be. He made some more windows. He made a big building full of windows. He made lots of buildings full of windows. He made a whole city full of windows. But none of the windows was his window. He couldn't think where it might be. He decided to ask the policeman. The policeman pointed the way Harold was going anyway. Let Harold think. And he walked along, wishing that he was in his room and in bed. Then, suddenly, Harold remembered. He remembered where his bedroom window was when there was a moon. It was always bright around the moon. And then Harold made his bed. He got in and he drew up the colors. A purple crayon dropped on the floor, and Harold dropped off the slip.
Candyland. It seemed like that.
There was candy everywhere and a kingdom up the road.
Dream poem, hidden. There I lie with someone near, for I have a fear. I wait and watch, hidden. Weeks go by when I sit and lie. Someone comes, I'm trembling. He lifts the blanket that I hide under, and my secret place is no longer secret. I need not to be afraid, for I am far away from what I ran from. I do not know why I ran. I ran for a great reason, though. Something that really mattered. Here I sit, with someone near, though I have no fear.
Dream poem, dreams. Wheat rustles, the doorbell rings. Checkerboards everywhere. I grow taller, then smaller. Do I breathe? An old man, an old woman, together, never enough. They love when they dream. When she left, I cried. Why did they take her? She didn't want to go. Red horns are always around the corner. Hold on to the halo while it lasts.